Now, as we've learned, variables are great for storing information, but if you find yourself needing to group multiple pieces of data, which makes sense to group, then you might want to go ahead and look into an array. Now before we start, let's go ahead and see what I've written so far. As you can see, it's nothing fancy, some variables and a trace statement call on all of them. Now notice, we could group these into some sort of group. So let's go ahead and call this my back to school list. So let's go ahead and make this array. Now first you type var, you enter your desired name, whatever you wish, then you enter your data type, which in this case obviously is an array. Now I'll be showing you three different ways to create an array, so choose whatever method feels comfortable for you. Now the first method involves typing new array, brackets, and a semicolon. And let's go ahead and just replace everything inside of this trace statement with our new array. Now if I were to test this, nothing would happen as we simply created an empty container. So let's add an item by using the push function. Now let's test it. Wonderful. The second way to create an array involves placing data within the parentheses. Just make sure you separate them by semicolons. And if you wish to add more data, of course you could always use the push function later. Lastly, we could trim some fat and use square brackets. I'll be using this method for the rest of the module. About our list, we've talked about adding an element with the push function, but we could also call, remove, replace, and get data on the list, such as the amount of items in the array. So let's talk about these. So let's start with an easy one. And access a specific item. With square brackets, we're gonna call on this array's index. Now an index is just a fancy word for an element's position on the list. In this case, let's call upon paper. Since paper is our second added item, I guess it makes sense to use the number 2. But this will actually bring up staples. Instead of starting with a 1, arrays start counting by 0. This is very important to remember. So to do this, I'll have to go ahead and type 1 so we can finally get paper out. Now let's remove some elements. Now we could delete the very last one, and again, this one function only works with the last one. We could use the pop function. We could delete a specific index by using the splice function. Now this is a little more tricky than just pointing to a specific index you want to remove. We'll also need to specify the amount of elements that we wish to delete moving forward. So let's give this a try. In this case, I wish to only delete staples. So this of course has the index value of 2, and I'll specify that I only want to delete one element. We could extend the amount of elements we delete from the index's starting point. In this example, let's delete staples and binder. This of course only needs you to remove the 1 and replace it with the 2, thus deleting 2 steps forward. We could also delete everything moving forward from the specific index. All we have to do is remove the starting point value, thus leaving only the index value. Thankfully, replacing something is a lot easier. We could do this by pointing to a specific index as we assign a new value. Here we will replace the word staples with CD. If you wish to know the length of your array, you could simply use the .length